Hey folks, Grant from GunSpot here for Tolster.com. In today's video, we're going to be talking about whether you should or shouldn't have a red dot on your EDC. Should you or should you not invest in a red dot on your everyday carry gun? In short, yes. This, if you know me personally, you know that a year plus ago, I would not have said that. However, I have come to the realization that a red dot on your carry gun, a red dot for defensive use, is only going to make you more effective no matter what your skill level is. Okay, that means if you are 35 years of hardcore iron sight shooter and you're fantastic, you can be even more fantastic with a red dot. Here's why. Well, first off, it simplifies the process. By simplifying, really what I mean is you no longer have to take into context front sight, rear sight, and apply them to a target. It's a more complex thing, aligning two things to a third thing. The dot allows you to maintain target focus, single focal plane, put the dot on it, and you know exactly where that gun is aimed. The only time that you're going to know exactly where your iron sights are aimed is when you have them aligned exactly and you have the time to make sure of that. The dot is king. It allows you to target focus. Gone are the worries of how am I going to align my sights when I'm overwhelmed with tunnel vision and I'm supposed to be aligning what's on the gun, but the threat is out there. I can focus on that threat now and still effectively aim because of the dot. I have personally been to multiple instructor level classes now that were red dot specific, and I was blown away by the quality of shooter with a dot as compared to without the dot. To prove all these things, I'm going to describe it with a hypothetical situation. We all know how to align iron sights. But can we or should we even consider taking a shot when our iron sights are just terribly misaligned? Of course, the answer to that is no. We would never take a shot if our iron sights weren't remotely aligned on the target. However, that is exactly what you can do when you have a dot. Anywhere in that field of vision that you see that dot is the aiming point that will bring you a point of aim, point of impact on your target out to about 20 yards. Beyond that, you start seeing a little bit of effect of parallax, but it is so negligible. And to be honest, our jerk of the trigger or our bad grip or our anticipation or pre-ignition push, whatever, you know, fundamental flaw that we can introduce is definitely going to be greater than the effects of that dot at the extreme. It's easier. It's effective. It provides you data that your iron sights just simply cannot provide. In closing, yes, you should put a red dot on your carry gun. To do that though, my best advice to you is don't shortchange yourself. By quality, you want something with a robust nature to it. Just because it's a red dot does not mean that it can be trusted. So go out, do your homework, do your due diligence to find out whether this particular brand Y is as good as this particular brand Z. You need something that can take a beating and still perform. I've seen iron sights fly off the gun, but nobody talks about iron sight failure. Red dot, it's a piece of glass in there, folks. It's got to be durable. It's got to be protected. All right. It is better, but it's not without some risk. So that's it for this video. Thank you for watching. And remember, train hard. Your family deserves it.